Hi guys, I'm Ramsharan. I work with Quintype. I'm the director of engineering at Quintype. Worked across multiple spectrums like healthcare, e-commerce, and publishing now. I've also worked on several tech stacks, Ruby, Clojure, Golang, Node.js, and also the front-end technologies. Primitively a Golang guy, came from that background. Didn't know a bit of Clojure before joining Quintype. Pardon me if I sound a little nervous, because I'm really bad at public speaking. So please laugh at all my jokes. And also, the last time I spoke in a conference, it was in a Ruby conference. The speech ended up being a conclusion to move to Golang. So you would imagine how that turned out to be. So before I start this presentation, I want to set out a storyline. This talk is basically about my experiences with lazy sequence, how I matured to just from learning it, making mistakes, and then how we matured to building a product from with lazy sequences. So when I joined Quintype, my first task was to build an indexer. An indexer is basically reading some data from the database and putting it into Elasticsearch. That was my first task. And because I'm a software engineer, what would I do first? I would go copy code. I copied the code. I put it into my editor. I'm also an Emacs guy, so I compiled that. I compiled the file about 10 times. Saved the file 10 times. And like any other software engineer, again, hot patched it in production. And this is how I did it. Right? I also had these fingers. It looked like the Emacs logo itself. So, coming back, I did this. And the next thing that happened on production was this. Right? This was my first interaction with Clojure, and there's an OOM kill, and my hopes were killed. So I didn't know what to do. I was panicking. So I went to one of my colleagues. Let's call this person Fubar, because I'm a developer. I don't like to name things. So I'll call this person Fubar. This person, Fubar, was really busy. So he told me, look at the code. It has a do all in it. Just replace it with a do seek. So I was about to ask him why, but in my panic, I just was not ready to do it. I went back, replaced it, evaled the file 100 times, saved the file 100 times, and then hot patched and brought again. Right? And this time, it worked like a charm. And as soon as it worked, I was a little relieved. And then I got down to the root of the problem. Right? What did I miss? How did just replacing a single function change everything? So I went to Mr. Fubar again, and I asked him, how does this work? How did you guess? He told me, I don't have time, just Google. So I went and Googled. Supposedly, all the documentation on do seeks and do runs, do alls, I came across a common terminology. It was called lazy sequences, right? So again, I like to talk to people and understand things. That's why I'm continuously going back to this Mr. Fubar. And I went and asked him what a lazy sequence is. And in the Clojure world, if you're entering Clojure without knowing what a lazy sequence is, you are an alien, right? This person looked at me, he walked out of the office, and thought that I shouldn't exist in this world. So I went and started Googling lazy sequences again. And there was another common terminology used in all the documentation. Was this, it was called consells, right? Lisp consells. I just want to divert a little bit towards the theory of Lisp consells so that I can build it up to what my understanding was. Lisp consells it took me back again to engineering, where I was studying computer science to become this useless programmer. It took me back to a concept called linked lists. So linked lists consisted of two parts. One is the value and the pointer to it, to the next value. Right, that's basically a consell. A consell is also made of two parts. One is the car, and the other one is the CDR. Car is the value of the consell, and the CDR is the next value it points to, or if it doesn't, it's just a standalone consell. You could have a list of consells. You could have a list of consells. So there's hybrid varieties of these. After looking at consells and learning about consells, came back to lazy Seqs. And then this is my interpretation. Lazy Seqs are not data structures. Just because they return a list, it's not data structures. I would, in my mind, lazy Seqs run as a, like a consell. It is just simply a cell which is of two parts. One is the value, and the other one is the side effect, right? And the side effect in closure is a function normally, right? So so when you call first on a lazy seek, what it does, it calls a function, then it calls the side effect. The function returns a value and a side effect, and we just respect the value. In case of rest, it does the other way around. It just calls a function, returns a value, and a function, it just respects the function instead of the value. That being said, lazy sequences sounds like a really nice concept, but I still could not figure out why is it so efficient, right? There has to be some reasoning behind this madness. So so again, I want to reiterate on what a lazy sequence is. A lazy sequence is a list of functions, algorithmically generated logical sequences, right, which do not have to reside in memory. So if you have a massive number of sequence, a huge list you want to iterate over, you don't have to keep this in memory. You can even iterate to infinity with lazy sequences, right? You can iterate to infinity, you can iterate to 1 million numbers, right? That's what I tried. I iterated to 1 million numbers, tried to batch them into three, and it took less than a millisecond. But I tried to load them into memory, it took me 3.2 seconds, right? That is the efficiency of the lazy seeks. As long as you don't realize them, this is the first time I thought realization is bad. You don't realize lazy seeks, they're really efficient. So I went back to Mr. Fubar. I told him, see, I learned all this about lazy sequences. This is what you taught me yesterday, and now I understand what you said. He gave me this. You must have heard this somewhere else also, right? Lazy Seqs make impossible possible. So you can do all the crazy iterations you want, which you could not do in a Java or in a Golang. You could do all that with lazy sequences. You iterate to infinity, find all the prime numbers until infinity, it's possible. Print all the prime numbers until infinity, it's very much possible in seconds. You don't have to, you don't even have to wait for minutes here. So now that I have a strong basics with a strong foundation with lazy sequences, I was trying to implement whatever understanding I had into products, into whatever products I build day to day. So a year back, we had a lot of clients coming into Quintype. So we were trying to import a lot of content from several external sources into Quintype. So we were trying to model this new product which could reduce our import time. So we used to take about a week to import huge publishers, and with the knowledge of lazy Seqs, we somehow managed to get it down to around a day. That's the level of optimization I could do because that's the competence I have. I want to just run through what is the kind of thinking we did to build this product. We did look at not realizing lazy Seqs throughout the code base. That was one of our aims. We did intentionally try not to do this because that is what created the huge memory block in our previous approach. So we tried not to keep things in memory, not to keep realizing lazy Seqs. So we even decided our input formats to run in such a way that it can all be loaded with lazy Seqs. So for example, we decided we would go with an input where we would just have a lot of JSONs in a CSV format. So basically, each line would just be a JSON. And there would be smaller batches. There would be small batches of files. So if you have, say, 1 million content JSONs, I would split that into 10,000 files, which is 1,000 files, 1,000 content lines a file, right? And the interesting part is how we got into processing it, right? Clojure makes it so simple if you just stick to Clojure functions. So I don't know if you can see the highlighted part, but you can see that the import content function has two channels. The input channel, the output channel. The input channel basically populates all the content from the files. And all these files are lazily read, so you don't spend much time on it. I'm not realizing it yet. So it will continue to be lazy. And it is sent to a pipeline, right? The input channel is sent to a pipeline, and there's some kind of decoration we need to do before sending it to our platform. So we would want to do that also lazily. So what we did is we used something called as transducers, right? Which is also lazy in nature. So we still haven't realized the function. We still haven't realized any channel. We haven't realized any lazy Seq. I think the last part I wanted to cover here is the reading of the file. Clojure gives us such advanced functions that you can maintain a file reading lazy throughout. For example, there's a line seek function which I didn't add in here. But what line seek does is it reads one line at a time, but keeps it in a lazy sequence. So you can keep the whole function in a lazy sequence, and it will be called only when it's realized. So this was our process of building the migrator. After building all this, you would realize that we do have a good understanding of lazy Seqs. But I'll show you what Mr. Foobar's recent commit. Right? We still don't have the understanding of lazy Seq. Actually, that's not true. He changed it himself. So he does have an understanding of lazy Seq. But it's really easy to make mistakes with lazy Seq. So even if you're taking extra time, make sure you don't realize lazy Seq too much. Try to use all the functional concepts so that you can maintain the lazy Seqs. That's about it. This is just about my experience with lazy Seqs. If you have any questions on what more mistakes I did, please come over to the booth. I'll be happy to discuss a few references, and that's it. Thank you.